Next method is AutoSum. The AutoSum function offers a shortcut to add up columns and row. So how you will use the AutoSum? Click on this cell, then click on AutoSum. I want to sum function, then write the sum. Okay, this is the way how to calculate the. Then I will select this cells E4 to EH4. Address is E4 to H4. Okay, with the help of AutoSum function. And if you want to calculate multiple columns or multiple row, so we will use a colon sign. Clear? Then press the enter key. This is the way using AutoSum function. And if you want to use in this cell also same sum function, in this cell also and in this cell also, then you will click on the right side of this cell, your file handle will become and drag down, so your automatically sum will be come. Clear? So this is the way how to calculate any function or any formula using AutoSum function or using formula method and start with equal to sign. Clear? Next is adding and removing a worksheet. We can add a worksheet and we can remove a worksheet easily. So to add a new worksheet, select the sheet before which you want to place a new worksheet. By default, when we open a Microsoft Excel, so by default 3 worksheets are there: sheet 1, sheet 2 and sheet 3. If you want to add more than 3, so you will click on the insert worksheet, and shortcut key of insert worksheet is shift plus F11. So you will simply click on it, so your new sheet will be come in your screen. This is the way how to insert a new worksheet. Next is removing a worksheet. If you want to remove any worksheet, place the mouse pointer on the worksheet tab that you want to delete and right click on the worksheet tab and select the delete option. Like I want to delete sheet number 3, so simply click on sheet number 3 and right click on it and click on delete option. This is the way how to delete the worksheet. Next is saving a workbook. How to save a workbook? Two methods are there. You will use the save, control plus S is the shortcut key of saving a workbook. And second method, click on office button, then click on save button. After clicking on save button, your save dialog box window will be appear. Write down the file name and write here file name, like my file name is class 6 data, and I have saved my worksheet on desktop and file name is class 6 data. Then click on save button. This is the way how to save the file. And I already told you, when we save our file, so your file name were shown on title bar. Now look here on title bar, our file name is class 6 data. Okay, hope so you all have understood about this chapter. So